How's it going, guys? I'm your host, Corban Gaming. Welcome back to this week's DragonFable release video. And as you guys can see, oh man, everything is on fire. Ash is literally on fire too. Wow. Oh, is this gonna come next week? I don't know, man, because like all the other games, Meteor are still pretty far away. The closest one has to be DragonFable, and like this is literally the definition of no chill. Yeah, so we might see the anniversary event next week, or maybe it's just for DragonFable, I don't know. Okay, so for this week's release, we have Book 3 Reimagined, Changing Winds. Okay, so this month's Book 3 Reimagined quest has arrived. With hopes of peace between the Vin and the Rose in shambles, and the looming threat of General Akantas, Kara is worrying about the fate of Sulan, Eska, and those who call it home. Head over to Kara's past quests in Sulan, Eska to play this week's Reimagined release as clouds gather on the horizon, Changing Winds. A quick update on the state of things. Unfortunately, Dove was sick this past week and I've been in a bit of a slump, so we aren't quite able to get everything done this week that we had planned. But we'll have the Bard Epoch all set next week for sure. Finally, guys. Wow, can't wait for Bard Epoch to come. Already got the calendar, okay, as you guys can tell from one of my past videos. Okay, I did showcase it. I'll link the video in the card in the top right corner of the screen right now if you guys want to check out my review on the calendar as well as the AQ items. Apologies for how long it's taken. So yeah, usually the particular year's calendar class for DragonFable, usually they release it around like January or February, but for this month looks like it's only going to come in April. That is totally fine though. It will have the same basic skill set as Eternal Epoch but with a different final. Okay, so it's going to be a bossing class like Eternal Epoch, and I think they did say in the past somewhere, I'm not entirely sure so don't quote me on this, that all the Epoch variants that we have right now are going to be final. They are not really going to come up with any more like different variants of Epoch. Might have some cosmetic changes here and there, so I think that's what they meant by a different final. I don't know if they are referring to just the animations or maybe like the skill itself is different. Okay, of course coding a work is coding an entire class is a lot of work, and I understand that maybe the staff doesn't want to waste so much time every year just on coding the calendar class. I mean, I'm totally fine with all the classes we have in the game right now, but I'm even more excited if we were to get Flash Reversal this year. So hopefully this means that they are going to dedicate more time to, you know, making Flash Reaver happen rather than, you know, spending all the time doing up another calendar class, which not everybody might have the privilege of buying because it is a very premium item. You have to buy the calendar from Hero Mart, and then like you still have to pay for shipping fees and all that kind of stuff. So yeah, totally understand. Also, a Lucky Day Storybook and March DC specials will be leaving with next week's release. If you guys want to check out my very, very short review on the DC specials as well as the important item to get from the Lucky Day Storybook, you can check out the short that I have over here. So it's less than a minute long, so it won't take out a lot of time of your time to go ahead and check that out. Make sure to check them all out before they leave for another year. Okay, so that's it. So this week is just a small Reimagined quest, so let's go ahead and check it out. I'll turn on my music first. Okay, so let's go to Sulan Eska, Changing Winds. Oh, come on. Come on, Kara. Wait, no, I think it's under old quests. Yeah, there we are. I have to do something. Everyone's counting on me, but I can't protect them from that monster. What to do? And... okay. It's happening again. It's all crashing down again. It's Kara, you need to rest. What I need is to make sure everyone's safe. Maybe you can head east. No, no, the Rose is sure to be blocking the roads. South, Doomwood will claim many, and Amityville is long occupied by the Rose. Kara, please, you are trying to help. Share your thoughts with us. We are all in this together. I can't, not again, not like the Sanctuary. I can't lose you too. If you insist on shutting us out, you're going to lose us whether you want to or not. The peace talks were important to you, but even if they failed, we can still move forward, right? There's no moving forward, not anymore. It's only a matter of time. A matter of time until what? Until General Akantas enters Betrobang at the head of an army and eliminates Sulan, Eska, and all who dwell here. You won't let that happen. Don't be foolish. Even Korriban couldn't do anything against Akantas. So what are the options? You want to flee? I don't know. We still have refugees who call Sulan Eskar home. We have folk who would rather fight and die than be uprooted once again. And even then, we have nowhere else to go. I hope that Jania would have been at the Pali, but I could reason her by Cantus. We had no resistance to him at the peace talks. He could have pressed his advantage, but he didn't. He just left. What makes you think he will attack Sulan Eskar? He wants the people of Greengard on his side. By provoking us into throwing the first blow, he gains legitimacy for his actions in the eyes of the people. As much as we may have grievances with the Rose, the fact remains that they are and have been a popular movement. But a movement based on fear and hate needs targets, or people will lose faith. He's manipulating them. The destruction of Sulan Eskar will be another target, another victory, and more power consolidated under Cantus' leadership. It happened with Popsprocket and it happened in the Sanctuary, it will happen again. And through all of this, not a single word from Jania. What makes you so sure she wouldn't approve of Cantus' actions? I know her, she wouldn't. I know. What if Cantus has her locked up somewhere and took over the organization in secret? It's a possibility, but true or not, that sort of speculation will help us now. Excuse me, I hope I'm not interrupting. The guesses are ready for you. Corbin and I can handle it. Mirta, can you make sure Kara gets some sleep? Of course, come on Kara, we can go over our options after you rested. Oh, tied up rogue soldiers, okay. Dragon here doesn't seem to be too happy. Some of the clocking will be by shortly if you need anything else. Thank you. So the prisoners are ready to talk, are they? Took some time to convince them we weren't going to eat them. Really? I wish. Wait, I know you. I remember you. Do you recognize this one, Corriban? It's me, Karat. You and that scary elf lady let me go. You were in the group that burned down the clocking settlement. Is that so? I tried not to do any actual burning. I was horrified. I gave you that scroll, remember? I heard about the attack on the border prison. Even after all that, you still stuck with the Rose? You don't get it. Once you're caught up in it, everyone treats you different. You're somebody. And the Rose pays well too. I had to take care of my family. Money and fame over morals, was it? Stop making them mad, Karat. I swear, after the incident, I requested a desk job, paperwork for border passage. But when I heard about the peace party, I just had to volunteer. And now you're here. What are you going to do with me, with us? We just have a few questions for you. Answer truthfully or fry you and eat you for dinner. Yeah, what the dragon said. I wasn't planning on hiding anything. You're supposed to be afraid of that tiny lizard. Spoke a bit too soon then. Say that again, I dare you. No, don't. I'm angry enough already. Oh, you better hold me back. How about you don't antagonize the fire-breathing world destroyer of prophecy? Sorry, I'm sorry. Yes, yep, understood. I'm watching you. Let's start with the questions then. What is Akantus planning? We don't know. Up until the fighting broke out, we thought it was just going to be peace talks. I don't think they'll be happy back in Soul Haven to hear that you attacked us. Kara's impression of the situation seems more and more like reality. What about Jania? What are her plans? Lady Jania leads the Rose to prevent the misuse of magic. It's rare that we get to see her in person though. Perhaps she's being used as a figurehead for whatever reason. That seems odd considering her actions in the conflict against Yala. You'll never doubt a hero like her. She saved the world twice already after all. It's true she hasn't made as many public appearances as before the war ended, but she just wants to keep everyone safe. Safe? Correct, you saw for yourself what the Rose did to the Clock Inn. Do people in Soul Haven really not hear about the enslavement and oppression? Alright, we are told a different perspective. It's all justified. Many genuinely believe in what they are doing. Others make themselves believe for the greater cause. So what if we brought it all to light? Show the people of Greengard what the Rose has been doing. No one will believe you. No one will want to believe you. Not the successors of the Sansi and Doomwood and beyond. Greengard as a whole is at peace. You magic users are stirring up trouble. I've seen many threats pop up as if from nowhere. Do you really think the Vin are the root of all magical problems? I don't see why not. It's all magic after all. Putting all the blame on a single name helps their cause. As much as I hate to admit it, Kara's option of going to hiding seems more and more like the safest choice for now. For the safety of all perhaps, but the Clocking will be hesitant to move from our lands once again. What's going to happen to us now? We can't just let them go. Can I join you? I'll get my family, leave Soul Haven, live here with the Vin. Correct, are you out of your mind? Although I guess it's better than being eaten. They're not going to eat you. Knowing what I know, I can't go back to the Rose. It'll be insufferable. Being surrounded by the beliefs that I know are wrong. I'm scared, but I want to learn more about the Vin, about magic. We'll take that into consideration. I knew it. They're feeding us to the dragons. I'm sorry. I what? Good, you're all here. Make sure the prisoners are secure, but we have to prepare quickly. Ogni spotted the Rose forces mustering on the western border of the swamp, more than any previous assaults. Are they insane? They will lose many in Betrubang before they even manage to reach Sulan Eskar. Something tells me the well-being of the soldiers isn't a priority in Acanthus' mind. There's still people, we can't let Acanthus use them as he sees fit. Ooh, is this going to be a war? Might be another war. So what's the plan? How's Kara doing? Kara is still recovering, I'm taking command with her blessing. The only thing I can think of is if we can hit them off at the border. If we can provide a big enough show of resistance, we might be able to push them back to regroup. Do you have enough resources to mount such an offense? I'm all for saving lives where we can, but we have to consider our own first. No, I don't. If only we had a few more dragon riders, I'm sure we'll succeed. But at the very least, we'll be able to buy time for Kara to lead the remaining refugees out of the swamp. What about Acanthus? If he's leading the charge, I don't know if we'll be able to stop him. Only didn't see any sign of him yet, but if he does take the field, there's nothing we can do. We'll have to retreat. The clocking will fight, but people grow wary of conflict, even for their own lives. We are carefree people. Being forced into courses takes its toll. Then we'll have to give the roles a show to remember. What do you think, Deshaun? Ready to fight against the odds once again? It's what we do best. Rita, how was Kara when you left her? I'm worried about her state of mind. The road to Falcon Reach is long and dangerous, especially without the company of your fellow Clockin. Take this, some traditional elven sweets to keep your energy up. Thank you, I understand most of my people want to stay, but my mind wanders and my legs grow restless. The gift is most appreciated. Come on, you don't need to be so formal. I'll have to visit you when this is all over, wherever you end up. Aw, that's so sweet. Whoa. Well, it's up to us to buy time for her to recover, but I don't know how long we'll last against an army. Whoa, is this a new soundtrack? Sounds like it. Whatever happens, the safety of the people of Sulan Eskar come first. Careful, careful. Nature magic is the essence of care, Wayne Elf. Just hold the rope steady. I'm sorry, I can't help but worry. These are our homes after all. If the rose makes it to Sulan Eskar, the extra reinforcement will do much help. You're right, apologies for my impatience. Oh, it's you, heading out to the border to face the Rose, are you? We'll send back up once Meta sends word to Omni. None of us can understand the dragon, but Ross a roar. Oh, and watch out for Tommy the Watchtower, he's guarding the other side of the bridge. He can sometimes be a bit over-enthusiastic about his job. Just stun him and he'll be no trouble at all. I'll help you, of course, but I'm busy keeping guard. Good luck out there. Wait, let's go back, see if we can find anything else. Wow, I have to say, and keep in mind, guys, this is in the middle of the quest, something that we've never seen before, like dialogue NPCs and like an actual place inside of a quest. Wow. Like these DF stuff just puts in so much amazing work, guys. Like I am absolutely blown away. The music is pretty fitting too. Yeah, I quite like the soundtrack. Okay, easy there, Tommy, don't want to hurt you. Eater of Lilies. Okay, so it looks like it's the same as the thousand floor top challenge thing. Oh, wait a minute. Huh? Okay, what's going on? I'll just stun it, is it? Okay. Oh yeah, okay, fine. Yeah, you can't damage him, you can just stun him. Okay, I actually tried to kill Tommy. Whoops. Looks like there isn't any way past other than through them, sorry. Okay, wildlife creatures, it's time to meet your doom. Kojidao. Okay, who is this? Back up here, huh? Took you long enough. The rogues have their camp just past the old border fence. With how much logging and digging they're doing, I guess they're planning on staying a while. I know you're the best, but be careful, there's a lot of soldiers and chained creatures. I'll be fine, once I finish this potion, I'll head back to Sulan Eskar. If you want to keep this conflict out of the swamp, we have a lot of work on our hands. The swamp's water just up ahead, right? Past the elemental. Nature elemental. Fairy circle far from home, but just as effective. Oh, okay. Hold on, we can probably sneak past that one. Yeah, actually you can. Whoops. But let's knock him out instead. Can you sneak? There's their camp over there. Alright, time to make some noise. Okay, you can't sneak past them. Okay, one is still alive. Seems she had a shield or something. And was that like a power? 180 defenses. Okay. We have a chance of hitting past that. I think we do. We can try. Yep. Should be able to hit past it now. But... Lady Jania? Oh. There are too many possibilities, too many threats to follow, but the path of the mirror doesn't show. A world without magic. No word yet from the Magi, but they are doing their best, they are doing their best. They'll find something, I know it. The answer is out there. Oh, okay. That's the end of the quest. Yeah, we might see a... war coming up soon. Sanctuary's Promise 7. So it's a trinket. Whoa! Endurance plus 50. Holy crap. Scar Wooden Charm was given to you as you prepare to leave Sulanska to fight the massing rose horses at the Swamp Border. May help you weather the coming storm. Whoa. New best in slot for min-maxing your endurance stat, definitely. Oh my god. What could this be good for? If you want to, like, let's say if you're like low on hit, let's say if you want to heal up but you're near high HP, then I guess you can equip this. Wait, no, not in the middle of a battle of a quest though. Yeah, I guess if you really just want need like very high HP for some weird reason, I guess you can use this. Yeah, because you can't change your trinkets in the middle of battle. I forgot that. Okay. Oh nice, we got the highest level version right off the bat. Awesome. Alright, so let me go ahead and showcase it. Wonder if there's any skills though. Sanctuary's Promise. Okay. Let's test this out against Volta Bolt. Oh yes, Ash is definitely on fire. Everything is fine, Ash. Everything is fine. Nothing to worry about, nothing to see here. Okay, no skills. Yeah, okay, no skills. Alright gang, I guess this is the end of the video. I hope you guys have enjoyed the episode. If you have, be sure to give this video a thumbs up. And of course, subscribe to this channel if you guys would like to see more of such future content. Till the next time, I'm your host, Corriban Gaming. Peace out.